Hi children, today you are going to learn 10th class 3rd chapter, that is polynomials. In that exercise number 3.2, already we have completed introduction about this chapter and 3.1 exercise. And in this exercise we are going to be discuss about the graphical representation of quadratic polynomial. Graphical representation of quadratic polynomial. How to find out zeros of the quadratic polynomial or any other polynomials, and by the picture, by the graph, how can we decide how many zeros a given graph has? How should we decide that a given graphical representation, how many zeros it has? So I'll tell you that suppose here as you know that every Cartesian plane, every graph will divide into the four quadrants like this. This is quadrant number 1, quadrant number 2, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. Quadrant number 1, 2, 3, 4, it is a x-axis and this is y-axis. And it is a x dash, and we call as it is a y dash, and this is called as a origin. As we know this already. So, if the graphical representation of a graph is like this, how many zeros this graph had? In the sense, it has two zeros. How can I tell it has two zeros? Because it is intersecting x-axis at two places. It intersecting at x-axis in the two places, so it has two zeros. So now this graph having three zeros because it is intersecting x-axis in three places. Now this graph will be having four zeros because it is intersecting x-axis at four places. Suppose now how many zeros does this graph have? You can say now 1, 2, 3. It has only 3 zeros. Should not tell that it has 4 zeros. Should not count the y-axis intersection point. Should not count that either graph is intersecting y-axis or not. It is not a matter. We should only mind it on that how many places it is intersecting on x-axis. In how many places it is intersecting on x-axis, as many zeros a graph has. Simple. Now suppose how many zeros this graph has? You should not say 1 because this graph has no zeros. Why it has no zeros? Because it is not intersecting x-axis. No matter either it is intersect y-axis or what. Only we should mind that either it is intersecting x-axis or not. It is not intersecting x-axis, hence it has no zeros. So mind it children, only one thing, in how many points it is intersecting x-axis, has many zeros a given polynomial has. Why I am telling you? Because based on this content, we have exercise number 3.2 first bit. First bit is based on only this content. So, second bit content I will tell later. First, I will show you the first bit on the screen. Please, you look at here. Yes. Now, you look at the first question. See that how many zeros it has now? Now it is intersecting only y-axis, so it is not intersecting x-axis. The first one has no zeros. We have to write what is the question actually. See, the graphs are y equal to p of x. Y equal to p of x in the sense, the given polynomial we have to assume like a y. The polynomial y equal to p of x are given pictures below. For some polynomials p of x, in each case, find the number of zeros of P of x. We have to find out the number of zeros of P of x. That means polynomials. So second one, how many zeros it has? See, it is intersecting x axis. Only you look at the x axis. It intersecting x axis. It only one place. So second one having only one zero. Now third one, at how many places it intersecting x axis? 1, 2, 3. Yes, it has 3 zeros. Now fourth one, it has 2 zeros. Fifth one, 1, 2, 3, 4. It has 4 zeros. Should not write 5. Only we should concentrate on the x axis. And at how many points it is intersecting x axis? How many zeros it has? Sixth one, look at that. 1, 2, 3. Yes, it has 3 zeros. Sixth one has 3 zeros. I hope you understood that first bit how to solve. Then we go for the second bit. We go for a second bit and we solve the second bit. We need to find out the zeros of the given polynomials in the second bit of 3.2. So find the zeros of the polynomials. There are 4 internal questions here. Let me solve the 4 out of 4 also. I solve the 4 out of 4 questions. Second bit. First question. P of x equal to 3x. P of x equal to 3x. How to find out the zeros of the polynomial? He has to find 0 of the polynomial. That means you make this polynomial 0. If P of x equal to 0, if this P of x you make it 0. If P of x equal to 0, you write what will get 3x equal to 0. 3x equal to 0. Now we need x value. See, this 3 will transfer this side. X equal to 0 by 3. 0 by something always 0. So x equal to 0. Yes, x equal to 0. At x equal to 0, the given polynomial is 0 of the polynomial. Therefore, at x equal to 0, the given polynomial, the polynomial P of x is equal to 3x is 0 of the polynomial. 0 of the polynomial. This you need to mind. Next, second one I will solve. See the second one. What is the second one? P of x equal to x square plus 5x plus 6. P of x equal to x square plus 5x plus 6. Let us find out the zeros of this quadratic polynomial. How to find out the zeros of the quadratic polynomial? This is very important, which we have already learned in our 6th class. So let's put, if P of x is equal to 0, then this becomes like x square plus 5x plus 6 equal to 0. We make like this. We get the x values. We'll find out the x values first. How can we solve this? Simple. Now we have to follow some rules here. Multiply the first and last term. X square into 6. That is 6x square. Multiply first and last term. X square into 6. That is 6x square. Now that 6x square we have to write as a product of two numbers. Product of any two numbers. Product of any two numbers. But if you add or subtract the two numbers, we have to get the same. So let me go for here. 2 3s are 6. X in 3x, x square I can take. Here you see, it is a plus 2, it is a plus 3. Plus 2, it is a plus 3. Plus into plus, plus, balanced. 2 3s are 6, it is balanced. X into x, x square it is balanced. Not only that, we have to check one more thing. Either if you add this or if you subtract this, you have to get the middle term. Splitting middle term, we will call this as a splitting middle term. If you add this both 2x plus 3x, we get 5x. Now it is balanced. When you find the product of first and last term, we are getting a 6x square. Now you write this 6x square as a product of any two numbers, not only 6x square. When you multiply first term and last term, whatever the number you get here, that number you have to write as a product of any two numbers. Any two, your wish. But when you add or subtract these two numbers, we have to get a middle term. That is very important. In such a way, we have to take a numbers. Now it is balanced. Now let me take here x square plus 2x plus 3x plus 6 equal to 0 I can take. Now in these two terms you see, in these two terms x we can take out common. Where x if you have taken common, here out of 2x, 1x is left, so one more x is left plus 2. 1x is already we took as a common factor. So out of 2x, 1x is here. Already this x we have taken a common, so 2 is there. From this 2x we cannot take out common factor because here there is a x, here there is no x. So we can take out a number 3. 3 we can take out a common factor. So if 3 is gone out, only x will be left. So 3 2s are 6, that is equal to 0. See, now in this, here we have to get same. In this first term x plus 2. In this second term, x plus 2, both are same. You have to get both same. In such a way, you have to take a common factor in the second time. First time, you take anything as a common factor as you wish. But in the second time, when you are taking a common factor, remember that you have to get same bracket values here also. In such a way, you have to take out a common factor. So, x plus 2, both are same. Now, let us take out x plus 2 as a common factor. So, in this first term, x is left. Now, in this second term, plus 3 is left. X, that equal to 0. Now, see here, x plus 2 into x plus 3 equal to 0. That means, x plus 2 equal to 0 and x plus 3 equal to 0. Where plus 2 you transfer this side, x equal to minus 2. And plus 3 you transfer this side, x equal to minus 3. Therefore, at x equal to minus 2 and minus 3 are the zeros of the polynomial p of x is equal to x square plus 5x plus 6. See, if you substitute minus 2 in this polynomial, we get p of x equal to 0. If we substitute minus 3 in this polynomial, we will get p of x equal to 0. Then only it is known as a 0 of the polynomial. So how to find out the 0 of the polynomial? This is important because this will help us in the third bit of graphical representation also. So please concentrate that. So next, we go for question number 3 and question number 4. Question number 3 and question number 4. Question number 3. See that p of x equal to x plus 2 into x plus 3. Already we have solved this. X plus 2 into x plus 3. P of x equal to x plus 2 into x plus 3. If p of x equal to 0, simple children. If p of x, if you make it 0, we get 0 of the polynomial easily. So without making 0 also we get answer, but if you write this p of x equal to 0, if p of x equal to 0, we get p of x, then 0 of the polynomial. Simple, x plus 2 into x plus 3 equal to 0. Just now we have solved here, just before form. The same thing we are going to do it here. X plus 2 equal to 0, x plus 3 equal to 0. Then x equal to here, plus 2 become a minus 2. Here, plus 3 become a minus 2. Yes, simple, completed. Now, here, instead of x, if you put minus 2, if you put a minus 2 here, so minus 2 plus 2, 0, 0 into this, completely 0. If you put minus 3, here minus 3, 2, minus 3 plus 3, it is 0, 0 into this, this will be also 0. So, therefore, minus 2 and minus 3 are zeros of the polynomial p of x equal to x plus 2 into x plus 3. Then we go for the fourth one and last one of this bit. That is p of x equal to x to the power of 4 minus 16. P of x equal to x to the power of 4 minus 16. X to the power of 4 minus 16. So very simple that first, if
if p of x is equal to 0, if p of x is equal to 0, then we get here x to the power of 4 minus 16 is equal to 0.
Now simple, what we have to do, this minus 16 you transfer this side, x to the power of 4 equal to plus 16. See that, let us make bases are equal, then exponents are also will be equal.
Then this 16 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, that is 2 to the power of 4 is 16. So x to the power of 4 equal to 2 to the power of 4.
When exponents are equal, then bases are also equal.
When exponents are equal, then bases are also equal. From the loss of exponent formulas, 4 and 4 equal, so bases also will be equal, that is x equal to 2. X equal to 2 here.
That simple. Therefore, x equal to 2 is a 0 of this polynomial.
X equal to 2. 2 is a 0 of the polynomial p of x equal to x to the power of 4 minus 16.
In this way, we can solve this also. This way we have completed exercise number 3.2 second bit. Now there is a third bit. Third bit is completely graphs. We have to draw the graphs. See, here I would like to tell you something regarding graphs.
Graphs I cannot draw on the board,
but I will tell you that how to solve the graphs. Okay, I will tell you how to solve the graphs and what kind of outcomes of graphs we will get in the quadratic polynomials. I will tell you what is the graphical representation of linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial and cubic polynomial also I will tell you here. So it will be a complete introduction about the graphs, and in this third bit we have only quadratic polynomial graphs. All these quadratic polynomial graphs already I have done on one paper in a graph book. I will show you the graph book directly. So in the graph book only I will explain you. Before that, I will explain what is the graphical representation of the polynomial first. I will explain that
graphical representation of polynomials.
Graphical representation of polynomials. What is meaning of graphical representation of polynomials? So we have going to be discuss in this chapter that about linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial and cubic polynomials. So let me go for this three types of polynomials. First one is linear polynomials.
Linear polynomials. We know that linear polynomial standard form like p of x equal to ax plus b. What is the zero of this linear polynomial? Always here, if it is p of x equal to 0, ax plus b equal to 0, then x equal to minus b by a. This, if you put in the place of x, how we solve just before in the bit, in that way, if you solve p of x equal to 0, then this b you transfer the side minus b. Now a is multiplied, so a will be divided. So minus b by a is the zero of this linear polynomial. In this way, we can find out the zero of the given linear polynomial. How to draw the graph of this? That means the linear polynomial graph always, see, the linear polynomial graph always, which is a straight line, okay? Straight line. It's get a straight line. That means it will intersect the x-axis at only one point. Either a straight line may come like this, either a straight line will come like this, either the straight line may come like this or any, but definitely it intersects the x-axis at only one point. That's why linear polynomial will be having only one zero. Linear polynomial will have only one zero because linear polynomial's graphical representation will intersect the x-axis at only one place, which we have already discussed in the exercise number 3.2 first bit only.
At how many points it intersect the x-axis, as many zeros a polynomial have. So a linear polynomial definitely it intersect the x-axis only at one point. That point is minus b by a. Suppose for example, p of x equal to 2x plus 3. 2x plus 3. This is a linear polynomial. 2x plus 3 is a linear polynomial. So if you draw the graph of this, x equal to plus 3, so minus 3 by 2. So it intersect the x-axis at minus 3 by 2. Minus 3 by 2 is x equal to minus 1.5. Definitely it will be intersect here. Suppose it is 0 and it is 1. Here it is 2. Suppose here it will be intersect. See, it is a minus 1.5. Minus 1.5. So definitely it will be intersect. The other points will be different. How? I will tell you how to find out the other points also. Very simple it is. The graphical representation will be very easy. Very easily we can score the four marks actually. So you remember, a linear polynomial will be having only one zero, that is x equal to minus b by a. It intersects the x-axis only at one point, and the graphical representation of linear polynomial is a straight line. Then we go for quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial. So we'll discuss about the quadratic polynomial now. In this quadratic polynomial, see, a quadratic polynomial may have the general form of quadratic polynomial p of x equal to ax square plus bx plus c. A quadratic polynomial, sometimes the quadratic polynomial may having one zero, sometimes a quadratic polynomial having two zeros, sometimes a quadratic polynomial will never have any kind of zeros also. So never have any kind of zeros also. So how to identify and how to write the quadratic polynomial which has one zero and a quadratic polynomial which has no zero? How to write and how to identify? I will tell you here itself. Just listen. P of x equal to, okay, here you write the polynomial which has two zeros. Suppose a polynomial can contains two zeros. A polynomial may contains one zero also. Sometimes a polynomial will never have any kind of zeros. Suppose in this way, if you solve in the like in the previous bit, in like a second bit, if at all you solve a quadratic polynomial, suppose if they have given a one quadratic polynomial to you, if they ask you to solve quadratic polynomial, sometimes some type of quadratic polynomial will get two zeros, like x equal to minus 2 minus 3, plus 2 plus 3, like that. Sometimes when you are solving quadratic polynomial, you get only one zero, that means x equal to minus 2 minus 2, minus 3 minus 3, minus 4 minus 4, like a same zero you will get, that is called only one zero. Sometimes you cannot solve the quadratic polynomial also. You cannot solve the quadratic polynomial. So why I am telling you about number of zeros of a quadratic polynomial? Because if you know the number of zeros of a quadratic polynomial, we'll also know that at how many points it intersects the x-axis. Because linear polynomial having one zero, so it intersects the x-axis in the graph at one point. Quadratic polynomial, it has two zeros, one zero and no zero. So sometimes a quadratic polynomial graph will intersect the x-axis two places. Sometimes a quadratic polynomial graph intersect the x-axis at only one point when it has one zero. Sometimes quadratic polynomial never intersect the x-axis. See how we'll do it. So first of all, I will tell you how to write a quadratic polynomial. Sometimes they may ask you question like this. You write a one quadratic polynomial. You write a one quadratic polynomial with your own example which has two zeros. ఏమంటాడు నువ్వు ఒక క్వాడ్రాటిక్ పాలినోమియల్ రాయి, దేనికైతే టూ జీరోస్ ఉంటాయో ఆ క్వాడ్రాటిక్ పాలినోమియల్ రాయండి. లేదు ఒకసారి ఇలా కూడా అడగచ్చు, యు రైట్ వన్ క్వాడ్రాటిక్ పాలినోమియల్ విచ్ హాస్ ఓన్లీ వన్ జీరో. సమ్టైమ్స్ దే మే ఆస్క్ యూ లేదర్ యు రైట్ వన్ యువర్ ఓన్ క్వాడ్రాటిక్ పాలినోమియల్, మేక్ ఆర్ ఫార్మ్ ఏ వన్ ఓన్ క్వాడ్రాటిక్ పాలినోమియల్, యు ఫార్మ్ ఏ వన్ క్వాడ్రాటిక్ పాలినోమియల్ విచ్ హ్యాస్ నో జీరోస్. So we should know that how to form a quadratic polynomial with their specific number of zeros. Let me tell you clearly, you need to also. First you write, it is a general example I am telling you. In this way you can remember. First x square and plus some plus you put like this. Okay. How many you want we can write like this. Okay. Then what we have to put here? We need two zeros, no? So you take any composite number here. I will write here the two. What? Composite number where in the constant place, the constant number should be composite number. Composite numbers, you know the composite numbers, no? Which are not prime numbers, they are called composite numbers. Which have more than two factors are known as a composite numbers. Let me write the composite number 6. Because 2 is a prime number, 3 is a prime number, 4 is a composite number, we can write. But 4 should not take here. Why should not take? I will tell you later. In the next bit, here you will learn that why should not take 4. You take composite numbers which are not perfect squares. The composite numbers which are not a perfect squares. Which are not perfect. Which are not perfect squares. That means if you take a 4, 4 is a perfect square number. 2 square is 4. That's why you should not take. 6, you can take, it is a composite number. Now, this 6 can be written as product of any two numbers. Like 6, how will you get 6? You write anything. 6, 2, 3 is a 6. 2 into 3, 6, no? This 2 plus 3 you do it. 2 plus 3, that you will get 5. You write here 5x. Write here 5x. Simple. Now let me write one more so that you can understand. P of x equal to x square plus and plus. You write a composite number. 9 is a composite number. 9 is a composite number. But it is a perfect square number also. Perfect square number. So should not take 9. See why I am telling you this. 9 should not take. You take 8, no problem. 8 is a composite number. 8 can be written as 4 to the 8. 4 to the 8 or 2 for the 8. This you have to add it. 4 plus 2, 6. Add it and write in the middle place. That is 6x. Now you definitely you solve this quadratic equation. How I solved here? By the splitting middle method. Just in the before problem. Like a second problem. In the second bit, second problem. How I solved? By splitting middle method. In that method, if you solve, you will get a zeros of the polynomial like a minus 4 and minus 2. Because here we have taken 4, 2 is 8. Sorry, 4, 2 is 8. 4 plus 2 is 6. Here plus 4 plus 2 we have taken. So when you split the middle term, you will get minus 4 minus 2 as a zeros of the polynomial. That means if you substitute minus 4 in this polynomial, you will get 0 of the polynomial. Minus 2 if you substitute also, you will get a 0 of the polynomial. So let me write P of x equal to simple. You can make hundreds, thousands of examples like that. You take here composite number, let me take 10. 10 is also a composite number. How can we write the 10? 2, 5 is a 10. 2, 5 is a 10. So 2 plus 5 is 7. That is 7x I will write in the middle. Simple. In this way, we can write infinite number of examples for a polynomial which has two zeros. Only a composite number we have to take which has not a perfect square. Okay, now we will write here a perfect square only will take. Here we will take only perfect square numbers. That means here let us take P of x equal to same x square plus and plus. Perfect square, 4 you take. 4 can be written as 2 into 2 only. There is no other chance. Because we are taking a constant number like a perfect square. 2, 2 is a 4. 2 plus 2, 4x. In the middle you write x square, x constant number. Like a x square plus bx plus c. Then second example. Here x square plus I plus. You write a perfect square. 3 square, 9 if you write. 9 can be written as 3 into 3 is a 9. 3 plus 3, 6x. That will write 6x. Now for example, P of x equal to x square plus plus, here I will write 49. 49. 49 is the same. 7 square. 7 into 7. 49 can be written as 7 into 7. This 7 plus 7, 14. You write, add it and write in the middle. That is 14x. In this way, we can write infinity number of examples of quadratic polynomial which has only one zero. Here we are discussing about no zeros, no? Okay, let me tell you about no zeros. Here you have to take prime number. We have to take a prime number. Simple. Constant place you take a prime number. Because prime number cannot be write as a product of two numbers. Prime number cannot be write as a product of two numbers. Suppose I will write a 5. How can you write the 5? 1 into 5 you cannot write. 1 is the common factor for every number. Other than 1 you write 5 as a product of two numbers. We cannot write. 2 5s are 2, 3s are 5. We cannot write write like that. Suppose you take a prime number 11. How can you write the 11 as a product of two numbers other than 1? We cannot write. So that's why we are taking here, which has no zeros in the sense. You write a prime number, it will never split as the two terms. So we cannot write anything. So x square plus, here you write any prime number. I will take one to be avoid the mistakes. Let me write here. Suppose 5. Here I will write any number like a 98x, 93x, 92, 70, 60. You write like anything. Why? Because when you multiply these two terms, we will get 5x square. This 5x square can only write 1 into 5, x into x. Now it is balanced. But when you add and subtract, we have to get middle term. 1x plus 5x, if you add, you have to get middle term. But we will never get a middle term. Such a middle term we will write here. Okay. Now we write E of x equal to x square plus, here prime number you take any prime number, suppose 11. Suppose I will take here 6x. Whatever, my wish, the middle term is my wish now, I can take any number. But in these two cases, the middle term we have to add it. 6, product of two numbers, that is 2, 3s are 2 plus 3, 5. 8, 4, 2s are 8, 4 plus 2, 6. 10, 2, 5s are 10, 2 plus 5, 7, like that. Here, 2 2s are 4, 2 plus 2, 4. 3 3s are 9, 3 plus 3, 6. 49, 7 into 7, 9, 7 plus 7, 14x. In that way we have to write. But in this case it will be different. You can write any other examples now. P of x equal to x square plus, you write here 97, suppose 97 is a prime number. 97 is a prime number. So write here, suppose 2x. Or any other numbers in the middle places. No problem. So now we have learned that we can able to form a quadratic polynomial. We can able to form a quadratic polynomial which has two zeros, which has one zero, which has no zeros also. You should be remember this, children. Not only quadratic polynomial, they may also ask a question. Form a quadratic equation. Form a quadratic equation which has two zeros, which has one zero, which has no zero. Ila kuda adugutadu. Quadratic polynomial ni form chese vidhanga rayandi. ఏదైతే ఒక క్వాడ్రిక్ పాలినోమియల్ విచ్ హ్యాస్ టూ జీరోస్ దాన్ని రాయండి, ఏదైనా ఒక క్వాడ్రిక్ పాలినోమియల్ విచ్ హ్యాస్ వన్ జీరో దానికి ఉండే ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ రాయండి మాత్రమే అడగడు. క్వాడ్రిక్ ఈక్వేషన్ కూడా అడుగుతాడు, బికాస్ యువర్ ఫిఫ్త్ చాప్టర్ ఇస్ క్వాడ్రిక్ ఈక్వేషన్. ఇన్ ద క్వాడ్రిక్ ఈక్వేషన్ దే మే ఆస్క్ యూ రైట్ ఏ క్వాడ్రిక్ ఈక్వేషన్ విచ్ హ్యాస్ టూ జీరోస్, రైట్ ఏ క్వాడ్రిక్ ఈక్వేషన్ విచ్ హ్యాస్ వన్ జీరో, రైట్ ఏ క్వాడ్రిక్ ఈక్వేషన్ విచ్ హ్యాస్ నో జీరోస్ అని. వాటికి కూడా సేమ్ ట్రిక్, నథింగ్ హ్యాస్ టు చేంజ్. ఓన్లీ వన్ థింగ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు చేంజ్. When they ask polynomial, you write P of x, P of x, P of x. When they ask quadratic equation, this in the case of P of x, you put 0. Simple. In the case of P of x, you put a 0, then it is a equation. If it is equal to 0, it is called equation. So now it is a polynomial, P of x equal to. Now polynomial. Polynomial. But if you want to write equation, just P of x, you rub it and put 0. It is a quadratic equation. Same kind of questions are also there in the fifth chapter. Remember this and try to solve that problems. Now a quadratic, a linear polynomial will having only one zero. It intersects the x-axis at only one place. Now here see, then quadratic polynomial, it has two zeros. It has one zero sometimes. It has no zeros also. Then how to identify? And how to represent the graphical representation you have to remember. In first case, if a quadratic polynomial having two zeros, what is the graphical representation of that? Either a graphical representation, always the quadratic polynomial graphical representation like a parabola. This is called as a parabola. So it is called as a parabola. The graphical representation of quadratic polynomial which has two zeros is either it comes upside parabola or not, it comes like a downside parabola. Upside parabola or downside parabola. So now we have to decide when we get upside parabola and when we will get a downside parabola. It depends on the question only. Simple. Here x square coefficient, see, only concentrate. If x square coefficient is positive, we get upside parabola. If x square coefficient is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, it is negative, then we get downside parabola. Simple. Only depends on the x square coefficient. x square coefficient. If it is a plus a, plus value, coefficient is plus, upside parabola. If coefficient is minus, then it will be downside parabola. Very simple. Okay. Now we know that how to solve the quadratic polynomials. We know the how to solve the quadratic polynomials, and we also learn that how to form a quadratic polynomial which has 2, 0, 1, 0, and no zero. And we know that the graphical representation of the quadratic polynomial which has 2, 0, that will get a parabola, upside parabola when coefficient of x square is positive, downside parabola when coefficient of x square is negative. So it has 2 zeros because intersecting the x-axis at 2 places. Now, if it has 1, 0, suppose it has 1, 0, what happens here? So it may intersect like this at only one place in the x-axis. Only one place. Here it is intersecting only one place. This is upside parabola where a is positive. Now we have the x square coefficient all positive only. Plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. So all these examples give us upside parabola. If I write here minus, that will be different. We will get a downside parabola. So either you may get like this or not, you may get like this. But see that. Either upside parabola or downside parabola, it intersects the x-axis at only one place when it has 1, 0. When it has no zeros, simply you can identify now, you can imagine the graphical representations has no zero. That means it will never intersect the x-axis. It will never cross the x-axis. It will never cut the x-axis. It passes like that somewhere in the quadrants. Either first quadrant, second quadrant, third or fourth quadrant, any quadrant, it will pass like that, but it will never intersect the x-axis. So now we know the graphical representation of a quadratic equation. Either it may intersect the 2 places, or not it may intersect at 1 place, or not it will intersect it. It will never intersect anything. So we know the outcome of the graph. Upside parabola or downside parabola, it depends on the coefficient of x square. If it is positive, we will get upside parabola. If not, we will get a downside parabola. This is main thing you have to remember, or not you have to make it notes, so we remember that. Next, third one is cubic polynomial. Cubic polynomial. Cubic polynomial. How to do the cubic polynomial? Simple. Suppose a cubic polynomial general form is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. So a cubic polynomial having maximum 3 zeros, maximum 3 zeros or 2 zeros or 1 zero. Definitely you may get minimum 1 zero. A quadratic polynomial minimum it will be get 1 zero, maximum it has 3 zeros. How to find it? Is there any trick to write the quadratic polynomial? Cubic polynomial like that? Definitely a cubic polynomial we have in either 3 zeros or 2 zeros or 1 zero. Minimum 1 zero, maximum 3 zeros. Maximum 3 zeros. Minimum 1 zero. That means maximum it intersects the cubic polynomial x axis at 3 places, or minimum definitely it intersects at least 1 place, okay, on the x axis. So how to get the cubic polynomial graph? In a sense, we have to solve it. There is not like a trick like this. We have to solve it and find out. Okay, now directly we go for the exercise. There I will tell you how to represent quadratic polynomial. 99% they will give you one question from this 3.2 third week. They'll ask you to draw the graph. They'll ask you to draw the graph of a quadratic polynomial. So here I will tell you the solutions. Here I will tell you the solutions, how to do it, and table also I will draw here. See that what are the principles we require. First word, third week. First question, third bit, first question. To explain the third bit, this is what we should be know the introduction. Okay. P of x equal to x square minus x minus 12. P of x equal to, this is the question. P of x equal to x square minus x minus 12. See, it is a composite number. Now, it is able to solve. That means we get a quadratic polynomial. Now, directly what you have can do it, see. This you can write by y equal to, first you write p of x, you remove it, you write this is y equal to x square minus x minus 12.
This is a given polynomial, y equal to p of x form. So we have written like this. Now what we have to do? Simple thing. Make a table. Make a table. Make a table. First you write here. First write here. What is the polynomial? Y equal to x square minus x minus 12. Here you write x, x values, here y values, here x comma y values, because
to represent on the graph paper we required x value and y values. So we'll assume x values, our wish, we can assume any x values, and here y, this given polynomial is y, nanduke y equal to rasam danne y. So what we need to assume here, that's your wish, you can assume any number. You can assume any number in the place of x. But always I suggest the children to be assume like a minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. If you assume 2 negative numbers and 0 and 2 positive numbers, it is more effective. It is very good to be represented. Okay. Then if you subtract the x values like this here, we'll get some value, y value. That means in the place of x, if you put 2, we get 1 y value. Here x comma y value, here x minus 2 and y value, whatever you get here, you have to write here. We will get some 5 points at least, 5 to 6 points we require. That 5 to 6 points you represent, float on the graph, will get a graph. Very simple it is. Very simple. All the kinds of graph will be same only. Either let it be, it is a quadratic polynomial or linear polynomial or cubic polynomial, anything. You have to do only one thing. Given polynomial, either linear polynomial or quadratic polynomial or cubic polynomial, you write y equal to. Here you write a box x. Here the given polynomial, whatever the type of polynomial you write here, x equal to, you assume some numbers your wish, you will get some y values here, x comma y values, you will get some points, no? That points you float on the graph. Finish. You will get a graph. Very simple. Any polynomial, a polynomial in gun. A polynomial y are going to write. X values కొని అనుకోండి ఈ x values ని ఇందులో సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేయండి x = -2 ఇక్కడ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేయండి ఇక్కడ y = కొద్ది వస్తుంది ఈ x y ఒక పాయింట్ ఏని x = -1 అనుకోండి x = 0 అనుకోండి 1 అనుకోండి 2 అనుకోండి మీకు ఇష్టం ఎంత అనుకోండి అలా కొన్ని పాయింట్స్ వస్తాయి కదా ఆ పాయింట్స్ ని గ్రాఫ్ పైన రిప్రజెంట్ చేస్తే మన గ్రాఫ్ అయిపోయినట్టు ఏ గ్రాఫ్ అయినా సరైంది ఐదర్ ఎనీ పాలినోమియల్ గ్రాఫ్ విల్ బి లైక్ దిస్ వన్ యు రిమెంబర్ క్యూబిక్ పాలినోమియల్ గ్రాఫ్ ఇలా వస్తుందని చెప్పలేదు కదా సింపుల్ క్యూబిక్ పాలినోమియల్ ఇలా సాల్వ్ చేసి ఫైండ్ అవుట్ చేయండి ఇక్కడ క్యూబిక్ పాలినోమియల్ రాస్తాం ఎక్స్ వాల్యూస్ అనుకుంటాం ఎక్స్ కామా వై వాల్యూస్ ఇక్కడ గ్రాఫ్లో ఫ్లోట్ చేస్తాం అంతే సో ఓకే మనకి ఇప్పుడు ఎక్స్ కామా కొన్ని పాయింట్స్ వచ్చాయి అనుకుందాం ఫ్లోట్ చేస్తాం మనకు తెలుసు ఇప్పుడు ఇది అప్ సైడ్ పారాబోలా డౌన్ సైడ్ పారాబోలా లెట్ అస్ సీ లెట్ అస్ ఇమాజిన్ సి ఎక్స్ స్క్వేర్ కోఎఫిషియంట్ ఇస్ 1 ఎక్స్ స్క్వేర్ కోఎఫిషియంట్ ఇస్ ప్లస్ 1 సో వి గెట్ అప్ సైడ్ పారాబోలా అప్ సైడ్ పారాబోలా Now the terms comes. If it is upside parabola, if it is intersect the x-axis at one place or two place or no, it will never intersect. That depends on this solving actually. This depends on the solving. How to solve this? See, very simple. By splitting middle method. If p of x equal to 0, then solve it. P of x equal to 0. Then what we get? X square minus x minus 12 equal to 0. You multiply these two numbers. X square into minus 12. That is minus 12 x square. Minus 12 x square, this we can write as a product of two numbers. 3 fourths are 12. X into x square. But see here it is a minus x. It is a plus sign, it is plus. Plus 3 plus 4 is plus 7. And manak 1 x only. So if you put here minus 3 and plus 4, minus into plus minus, 3 fourths are 12. X into x square. Ikkada balance ani. Ikkada chudam. 4x minus 3x plus 1x. Then ikkada minus 1x undi. So minus are ikkada pettali. Now it is balanced. See. Plus into minus minus 3 4s are 12. X into x square. Then you multiply this. You are getting this. When you subtract this, you will be getting this. This is called splitting middle term. First and last term multiply jayati ka rayam. E numbers ni product of any two numbers ka rayam. You write product of any two numbers. Here we write 3 into 4. No problem. Then you have to check once again symbols, numbers, variables. You check, you are balancing it. Okay, then after you add or subtract this both, it should be balanced here also. Then x square plus 3x
This minus x we can write as a plus 3x minus 4x minus 12 equal to 0. Then see that you take out x as a common factor, x plus 3 will be left. Minus 4 you take out common factor, x plus 3 will be equal to 0. See, x plus 3 will be same. Minus 4 I have to take out common, then only x plus 3 I am getting this. See, minus 4 into x minus 4x plus into minus is minus 4, 3 is 12. Will we get the same? Now x plus 3 you take out common factor, we get x minus 4 equal to 0. Then x plus 3 equal to 0, x minus 4 equal to 0, where x equal to minus 3, x equal to 4. See, that means it intersects the x axis at 4. And here is minus 3.
Now we know the complete about the graph. It is a quadratic polynomial, so parabola. Coefficient is positive, so upside parabola. ఎక్కడ ఇంటర్సెక్ట్ అవుతుంది? ప్లస్ 4 మైనస్ 3 దగ్గర కూడా ఇంటర్సెక్ట్ అవుతుంది. అంటే దట్ మీన్స్ ద కంప్లీట్ అవుట్కమ్ ఆఫ్ ది గ్రాఫ్ వీ నో ఇట్ నౌ బిఫోర్ సాల్వింగ్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్. మనం సాల్వ్ చేయకముందే మనం ఖచ్చితంగా అది ఎక్కడెక్కడ ఇంటర్సెక్ట్ అవుతుందో తెలుసుకోవాలి. ఇది చేయడం నెససరీయా? ఇట్ ఇస్ నాట్ నెససరీ టు డూ దిస్ ప్రాబ్లమ్. డైరెక్ట్ యూ కెన్ గో ఫర్ ద టేబుల్, ఫైండ్ అవుట్ సమ్ వాల్యూస్ అండ్ ఫ్లోట్ ఆన్ ద గ్రాఫ్, దట్ ఈస్ ఎనఫ్. బట్ ఇఫ్ ఎట్ ఆల్ యూ డూ దిస్, ఇట్ విల్ హెల్ప్ యూ దాట్ టు get the answer. Suppose now in that way I will assume, normally I will assume these numbers, but you see here plus 4 and minus 3 are intersecting, plus 4 and minus 3 are intersecting. So what I will assume here, here I will assume minus 3, or not I will go for the minus 4, minus 3, here 0, here suppose I will take any numbers, it is our wish we can take 2 and 4 suppose, let me take like this. Are not 4 and 6 I will take, 4 and 6, that means graph I will get some big like that. If you take minus 3 here only, our graph will be cuts only here like that. So minus 4 will substitute here,
minus 3, 0, 4 and 6. I got answers. When I substituted minus 3 in the given polynomial, I got answer as a 0, and when I substitute the 0 in the given polynomial, I got minus 2. When I substitute the 4, I get 0 as an answer. When I substitute the 6, I got 18 as an answer. Now, let us see how to. We got a 5 points, no? Minus 4, 8, minus 3, 0, 0, minus 12, 4, 0, 6, 8. These points, let us float on the graph now. So, I cannot draw the graph here completely, no? So, already I have solved this problem on the graph paper. So I will show you the graph paper. From the graph paper you will come to know this, how to draw the graph. Not only this question, the next further questions of this beat also I have drawn on the graph paper. You just look at the graph paper and try to follow the same thing and practice well. See here, the same question. But see, I have assumed here minus 4, minus 3, 0, 3 and 4 I have assumed. So when I substitute this minus 4, I got 8, and minus 3 when I substitute, as we know we got x equal to minus 3, no? It will be 0. Then similarly I got this answer. These are the points I got. So let us see how to locate these points on the graph paper. Just remember those points I am substituting here in the graph paper. First in the graph paper, main must and should write x axis and y axis. Scale should be very careful, you have to write. 1 unit equal to how many centimeter on x axis and y axis also. And x axis and y axis 1 unit equal to. Y axis 1 unit equal to 1 centimeter. X axis 1 unit equal to 1 centimeter I have taken, because the given, the points which I got here, that is sufficient on the graph paper. Simple. One point will take it and substitute here. Yes, the first point is minus 4 comma 8. Let us see where is the minus 4 comma 8. Here minus 4 and 8 on y axis. Minus 4 comma 8 is here. Then the next point is minus 3 comma 0. Here it is minus 3 comma 0. Next point is 0 comma minus 12. So here it is 0 on the x axis, minus 12 on the y axis. The next one, the next point is 3 comma minus 6, as you can see in the table. Here plus 3 and minus 6 on the y-axis is here. And next 4 comma 0, it is a 4 comma 0 here, till somewhere will extend like this to show it is like a actual quadratic polynomial. To show actually quadratic polynomial, we have to extend like this. Not only at this point will some extend like this, no problem. Okay, we'll assume like that only. Now at last you have to write, this is the graphical representation. With this you will get a 100% 4 out of 4 marks. Then we have to write here. Here I forgot to write. For this graph, definitely we have to show arrow marks. And P of x equal to, what is the polynomial? X square minus x minus 12. This is what we have to write like this. See, this is a way of representing of quadratic polynomial of first one. So next problems also I will solve it. What is the next question? That is, see that the second question is x square minus 6x plus 9. So x square minus 6x plus 9. See, this, if p of x equal to 0, if p of x is equal to 0, then what happens here? P of x will be getting 0. That means x square minus 6x plus 9 equal to 0. See, x square plus 9, it is a 9x square. 9 can be written as 3 into 3, that is 9, minus into minus plus x into x is x square. It is balanced. When I multiply these both, it is equal to 9x. When I add these both, I will get minus 6x. See, minus 3x minus 3. Minus 6x. Then from this 2, minus 3, x I have taken a common factor, so x minus 3, and minus 3 I have taken out common factor, x minus 3 equal to 0. X minus 3 of x minus 3 equal to 0. Then here I got x equal to 3, x equal to 3. That means, it means that x equal to only 1 0. It has only 1 0 because this 9 is a perfect square number. The 9 is a perfect square number. If it is a perfect square number, as I told, it has only 1 0 like. So x equal to 3, x equal to 3, it is not a 2 zeros, it is only 1 0 because x equal to only 3. Now, here you assume x equal to 3 on the x values. When you are assuming x values, you make sure that x value will be there here. If not, what happens, sir? Nothing will be happens. But you have to produce the numbers like, you know, if you substitute this x equal to 3 here in the assuming x values, then it is a more clarification we get. In the outcome of the graph, we'll get very clearly. If at all you don't do this also, this process, if you don't do it also, no problem. Directly you can go for the table and substitute the values on the graph. You'll get answer. You'll get a full marks also. But this we are doing for our satisfaction to get full marks. Okay, see, now I assume the same number. This I have to assume like a y equal to, no, x is here. Y is nothing but our given polynomial, x comma y. I assumed minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. I also assumed 3 this time because 3 is our 0 of the given polynomial. So when I substitute the 3, I'll get 0 in the y place. Not in any other values. Only at x equal to 3 only, I'll get y equal to 0. Because at x equal to 3, it is known as a 0 of the polynomial. Not in the other cases. So now you can see that substituting values directly. So I got those values now. These 5, 6 points, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These 6 points I'll be floating on the graph here. You can see those 6 points here on the graph. See very clearly. If you write quadrant number 1, 2, 3, 4 or not, it is your wish. It's up to you. See that? Here you should write x axis, here you should write a y axis, it is a x dash and it is y dash. Okay, so scale you have taken a different, because scale you has taken a different, see, it has taken a different. Y axis 1 unit equal to 5 centimeter, x axis 1 unit equal to 1 centimeter. See, y axis 1, so 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40 like that. Here also minus 5, minus 10, minus 2, minus 15, minus 20 like that. So substituting values. What are the values we got? See, minus 2 comma minus 25. Here minus 2 is here, minus 25 is here. Here, okay, little you can extend this graph again. Like this, no problem. Okay, now next, what is the point? Minus 1 comma 16, next. Here minus 1, it is already 10 here. Okay. count here 15. One more point we have to get here. Suppose it will get here. Yes, minus 1 comma 16. Next word 0 comma 9, 1 comma 4. Here 0, x value 0 and 9 will be here. Because 10 comes at exactly here. So 0 comma 9, then 1 comma 4. 1 comma 4 in the sense below the 5. This box complete unit will give us 5. So 1 or 2 will, 2 will be below that. Next 2 comma 1, 3 comma 0. Here 2 comma 1, 1 in the sense only 2 points you check. 2 small units, subunit, 2 subunits you have to check. Carefully you substitute. Next 3 comma 0. 3 comma 0 will be here. This is what. Now that I will write the polynomial name, p of x equal to, don't forget to write it, x square minus 6x plus 9. This is a required graphical representation of the given question. Similarly, we'll be having third question here. See that? Third question. X square, p of x equal to x square minus 4x plus 5. Here, I did not solve values. Why? Because of, it has no zeros, because here the constant term is prime number. If it is a prime number, you cannot split into the middle term. You cannot split into middle term. We cannot write as a product of two numbers this 5. So this will never satisfy. That means it will never intersect the x-axis. See, as I assumed, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. So these are the values we'll get. Let us see the graph now. You see the graph, and please pause this graph and you can continue the inverse. So it is a x-axis and it is y-axis. It is a x-dash and it is a y-dash. Okay. X-axis 1 unit equal to 1. Y-axis 1 unit equal to 2 centimeter. Then the points which we got it here, the same 5 points we have located here. We have located here. You should not say that it is intersected the here. Let us see. It intersected here. Let us see the point minus 2 comma 17 here. Next to minus 1 comma 10. Minus 1 comma 10 is here. Next 0 comma 5. 0 comma 5 will be here. Next 1 comma 2, 1 comma 2 will be here. Then 2 comma 1, it is 2 comma 1, it is not intersecting, see, it comes like this and move, sorry, 2 comma 1 will be here actually. With a thick pencil, I have drawn, so it will be difficult, but it is not intersecting the x-axis, it is passing through the, above the x-axis, see. X-axis here, it is passing like this. So it is p of x equal to now x square minus 4x plus 5. In this way we can complete this, children. Now next one and last one of this, it is that, see, fourth one, x square plus 3x minus 4. This we can split because 4 is a perfect square number. Okay, but see that we have solved this now. As we got x equal to minus 4 and minus 1, when we are able to split this, you split it. Whatever the two zeros you are getting, by doing this, it is very helpful because these zeros we can assume here, minus 4 and 1. At minus 4, it will give us 0 as the answer, minus 4 comma 0. At 1 also, y equal to 0, y equal to 0. That is 1 comma 0 here, 1 comma 0. 1 comma 0. Okay, then see, at x equal to 4 and x equal to minus, at x equal to minus 4 and x equal to plus 1, it is a 0 of the polynomial. So substituting values, by substituting values we'll get like that, minus 5 whole square is 25, minus 15, minus 4, that is 10 minus 4 is 6, minus 5 comma 6. Like that, minus 4, if you substitute, will get 0 definitely. When you substitute 0, you will get minus 4. When you substitute 1, 1 comma 0 you will get. When you substitute 2, will get 2 square value 4. 3 into 2, 6, minus 4, plus 4, minus 4 get cancelled, and 6 is the answer, that is 2, 6. These are the important points. Please note down this point and float those points here. See, definitely it is intersecting at minus 4, 0 and 1, 0. So you write here polynomial P of x equal to x square plus 3x minus 4. 3x at minus 4. In this way, we can complete the graphs. I hope you understood clearly all these graphs. Once again, see that all these are parabola, because all the questions are upside parabola only. Upside parabola.
Now, the last problem of this exercise, is check whether minus, fourth question, check whether minus 1 comma minus 1 and 1 by 4 zeros of the polynomial 4x square plus 3x minus 1 or not. Let us check, children. Here P of x equal to 4x square plus 3x minus 1. We have to check 1 comma minus 1 and 1 by 4. 1 comma minus 1 comma 1 by 4. These three are the zeros of this polynomial or not. Let us check. First, at x equal to 1. At x equal to 1. In this, we will substitute x equal to 1. P of 1 equal to, it is 4 into 1 square plus 3 into 1 minus 1. So P of 1 equal to 1 square value is 1 only. So 4 into 1 plus 3 ones are 3 minus 1. So P of 1 equal to 4 ones are 4. 3 minus 1 is 2. 4 plus 2 is 6. So P of 1 equal to 6 we got. 4x square plus 3x minus 1. Yes. Here at x equal to 1, it is not a 0 of the polynomial. Now, at x equal to minus 1, we will check. So, P of minus 1. P of minus 1 equal to 4 into minus 1 whole square plus 3 into minus 1 and minus 1. So, P of minus 1 equal to 4 into minus 1 whole square is plus 1, because square is an even number. Plus into minus, minus 3 and minus 1. So P of minus 1 equal to, here 4 into 1 is 4, minus 3 minus 1, minus 4. Plus 4 minus 4 will be 0. So P of minus 1 equal to 0. So at x equal to minus 1, this polynomial is 0 of the polynomial. Next, at x equal to 1 by 4 we have to check. At x equal to 1 by 4, let us check it. P of 1 by 4 is equal to, here 4 into 1 by 4 x square, because it is a x square, plus 3 into 1 by 4 minus 1. So let us check, P of 1 by 4 is equal to 4 into 1 square value is 1, 4 square value is 16. See, we have to do the whole square, numerator and denominator, both we have to do the square. Plus 3 ones are 3 by 4 minus 1, here 4 ones are 4 4s are 16. So P of 1 by 4 is equal to 1 by 4 plus 3 by 4 minus 1, I will write as a 1 by 1. 1 I will write as a 1 by 1. So do the LCM now. If you go for a LCM, you will get here LCM as a 4. Now let us check that 4 1s are 4. 4 1s are 4. 1 into 1, 1. See, plus, right plus. 4 1s are 4. 4, how many times are 4? 4 1s are 4. This 1 into numerator. 1 3 is 3. Here there is a minus. 1 4s are 4. 1 4s are 4. 4 into numerator, 4. Now let us check that P of 1 by 4 is equal to 1 plus 3, 4. Here minus 4 by 4. 4 minus 4 is 0. P of 1 by 4 is equal to 0 by 4, where P of 1 by 4 is equal to 0. Therefore, we can write now very clearly here minus 1 and 1 by 4 are zeros of the given polynomial. Therefore, minus 1 and 1 by 4 are zeros of the polynomial. Polynomial P of x is equal to 4x square plus 3x minus 1, but not 1, but not 1, in the sense at x equal to 1, it is not a 0 of the polynomial. I hope you understood this problem and also this exercise completely. Okay, I gave my maximum. Okay, if you did not understand, you watch this video once again to make you completely understood. Then exercise number 3.2 is completed. Third bit is very important. For the third bit only has taken much time, because definitely there is a one question for 4 marks. Please watch once again and practice the graphs. Practice graphs. If you practice graphs, there is a chance of scoring 4 marks definitely. So, thank you for watching this. Have a nice day. Bye.